विविधता। 22 जून को अफगानिस्तान के खिलाफ महेंद्र सिंह धोनी का बल्ला क्या नहीं चला, हर किसी ने उनकी बल्लेबाजी, उनकी परफॉर्मेंस, उनकी उम्र को लेकर सवाल करने शुरू कर दिए। ऐसा नहीं है कि किसी छोटे प्लेयर ने उनकी आलोचना की हो, बल्कि क्रिकेट के भगवान कहे जाने वाले सचिन तेंदुलकर जैसे खिलाड़ी ने धोनी जैसे खिलाड़ी पर उंगली उठा दी। वो धोनी जिसका देश क्या दुनिया भी लोहा मानती है, यहाँ तक कि भारतीय क्रिकेट टीम के मौजूदा कप्तान विराट कोहली तो माही को अपना गुरु तक मानते हैं। लेकिन मात्र एक मैच जिसमें धोनी ने 52 गेंदों पर 28 रन बनाए, इसको लेकर वो कई पूर्व खिलाड़ियों के निशाने पर आ गए। सचिन तेंदुलकर के बाद पूर्व भारतीय खिलाड़ी वीरेंद्र सहवाग ने भी इशारों इशारों में धोनी पर हमला कर दिया। हालांकि उन्होंने अपने बयान में स्पिनर्स के खिलाफ रक्षात्मक होने को गलत बताया है, धोनी का कहीं नाम नहीं लिया है, लेकिन माना यह जा रहा है कि वीरेंद्र सहवाग के निशाने पर धोनी ही थे। इनके बाद बारी आती है पूर्व ओपनर वीवीएस लक्ष्मण की, जिन्होंने तो वेस्टइंडीज के साथ 27 जून को खेले गए मैच में, इंडिया के मैच में धोनी पर गंभीर इल्जाम लगा दिया। उन्होंने तो कप्तान विराट कोहली के विकेट के लिए भी महेंद्र सिंह धोनी को ही जिम्मेदार ठहरा दिया, लेकिन जिसका विकेट गिरा यानी कि कप्तान विराट कोहली का, इससे बिल्कुल अलग सोचना है। उन्होंने भले ही मैच जीतने के बाद अपने बल्लेबाजों से असंतोष जताया हो, लेकिन उनके बयान से लगता है कि धोनी से उनको कोई परेशानी नहीं है। तभी तो धोनी के आलोचकों से टीम इंडिया के मौजूदा कप्तान विराट कोहली ने उनका बचाव किया है। मैन ऑफ द मैच की ट्रॉफी लेने के बाद कप्तान विराट ने कहा, धोनी जानते हैं कि मैदान पर क्या चाहिए। जब उनका बुरा दिन होता है तो हर कोई बात करने लगता है, हमने हमेशा उनका समर्थन किया है। धोनी के बारे में सबसे अच्छी बात यह है कि जब आपको आखिरी में 15-20 रन चाहिए होते हैं तो वो आपको दिला देते हैं। उनका अनुभव 10 में से 8 बार हमारे काम आया है। आगे कोहली कहते हैं, पांड्या ने बेहतरीन बल्लेबाजी की और धोनी ने अच्छी तरह पारी खत्म की। जब ये दोनों इस तरह से खेलते हैं तो हमें अच्छा स्कोर मिलने की उम्मीद होती है। जबकि बाकी सभी बल्लेबाजों में से बिना किसी का नाम लिए कप्तान कोहली ने कहा, मुझे अपने बल्लेबाजों से कुछ नहीं कहना, उनको अपनी मजबूती और अपनी कमजोरी के हिसाब से तालमेल बैठाना होगा, साथ ही पिच के मुताबिक खेलना होगा, ये मेरी रणनीति है। मैं अपने तरीके से खेलता हूँ, मैं 1-2 रन लेकर खुश हूँ, मेरे अधिकतर रन इसी तरह से आते हैं, हमें 2 मुश्किल पिचे मिली हैं, लेकिन मैं अपने योगदान से खुश हूँ। तो पूर्व कप्तान महेंद्र सिंह धोनी के आलोचकों को कप्तान विराट कोहली की तरफ से उनका जवाब मिल गया होगा कि भले ही एक मैच में धोनी का बल्ला नहीं चल पाया हो, उन्होंने ज्यादा बोलों में कम रन बनाए हो, लेकिन जब कोहली और टीम को धोनी की जरूरत होती है तो सही समय पर सही योगदान टीम को धोनी दे देते हैं, जो कि बहुत जरूरी होता है।
Three games, I think we put up some really big scores, and Afghanistan match, the wicket was a little sticky. It was tricky to bat in those circumstances. So I think it's a question of adapting, understanding these conditions and adapting to that.
Hello, just a question. This World Cup is dominated by the left-arm fast bowlers. So typically how we actually prepare ourselves, because we don't have one right now, but if you see the Michel Starc, Badenhoff or Bolt or even Cottrell, so how we prepare from a bowling unit, how we prepare our batsmen from the left arm fast bowler in absence of our own or even in the practice bowlers?
We had Khalil with us as our net bowler, and also we have a throwdown specialist who's particularly a left hander. So I think we have enough practice of the left hand bowling as of now.
Coach, can you just talk about the evolution of Hardik Pandya as an ODI bowler? I mean, 2017, there were some doubts about his ability to bowl 10 overs. Last game we saw, even though he took a hit, bowled a full spell, Kedar was not even used in that, on that sort of a pitch. So can you just talk about what he's added to his arsenal as a bowler in ODI cricket?
I think over a period of time, it was a big challenge for him to bowl those 10 overs. And he did realize that to be able to bowl those 10 overs, I'll have to develop a certain armory in my bowling. And that's exactly what he worked on. He's worked on his slow balls. He's worked on his slow bounces also. And also he's worked on perfecting his bouncers. So all these put together have given him the confidence to go through those 10 overs.
Does the fact that England lost yesterday take the pressure off you heading into the rest of the group games?
Actually, we are not even thinking of those matches. We are looking ahead and looking at the matches that we are going to play. And we are absolutely focused on the next game.
Coach, there was a rare kind of a dot ball percentage of MS Dhoni's innings was quite high in the last match. Is that a matter of concern of the Indian middle order kind of going into a bit of a shell going forward? How big a concern is that?
Not really. I think according to the situation and the condition of the wicket, we were able to successfully defend the total that we put up. And had we probably lost a wicket at that stage, then things would have turned out differently. So I don't think it's too much of a concern for us right now.
Sir, if we look at the innings that Kohli played on that same track, it didn't look much difficult. He was scoring at more than 100 strike rate. And then MS played that innings. As you said, it's a tricky thing. Like, there has been a few innings like this on and off in the last 2 years. So does anyone from the team management, does the head coach or the skipper or the coaching staff, do they speak to MS, or it's a case of since he has played a lot of cricket, he's left to his own devices to plan? Like, how does it happen?
To answer your first question, I think Virat Kohli is probably the number one batsman across all formats. So I think to even compare anybody to the way he plays is not right. And there is a constant dialogue between all the batsmen, the support staff, the batting coach, the head coach Ravi Shastri has a constant dialogue with all the coaches. I can't really get into the brass tacks of what we discuss, but yes, if I have to answer your question, there is a constant dialogue for us to improve.
Coach, you had earlier said that Bhuvneshwar Kumar was the first choice pacer ahead of Shami. Now with Shami coming in and doing well and Bhuvneshwar injured, does that change or will Bhuvneshwar be the first choice, especially because he adds some depth in the batting as well when he gets fit? And how is he now in terms of fitness?
Bhuvneshwar's injury is not of any great concern. It was just a niggle, which we didn't want to take a chance. And also it was an opportunity for us to blood Shami into the games. The fact that he's done exceptionally well augurs well for us. It's an embarrassment of riches. And we would take a call as per the conditions. Bhuvi has also done exceptionally well. So I think it's a pretty good headache to have.
Just keeping in mind 3 matches in the next few days, 6 days or something, what is it that what's the message that you're giving your bowlers, the whole bowling group, that other than the workload management, what do they need to focus on to keep themselves fit for the playoffs if India make that?
I think here in the World Cup, every match we are playing a different team. So I think for the bowlers to do well, they need to be aware of the batsman's strength and their shortcomings. So I think what they really focus on, they have enough breaks between the games, and as you rightly said, their workloads have also been managed. What they really work on is the mindset and the strengths and weaknesses of the opponents.
Yes, sir. Bharat, across the board, both fast bowlers and spinners have done well in this tournament and in the past also. As a bowling coach, how have you managed the spinners and fast bowlers simultaneously? So if you can throw some, how managing spinners, how difficult or easy or how convenient or comfortable for you?
Actually, I think if you don the role of a coach, you should be equally adept at both the skill spin and fast bowling. It's about understanding both. That gives you the best chance to manage them. As for the spinners, I think, again, as I answered the earlier question, the more you are aware and the more you understand what you are capable of doing, these two factors would ensure that you have the best platform for you to perform. So if you ask me how easy or how difficult it is, I don't think so. I think it's about empowerment And the more knowledge he has about himself and of the opponents, that would help any bowler to do well.
Coach, how do you look at the West Indies batting challenge considering the familiarity with all the players? So do you see this as a different kind of a batting challenge for the bowlers, and how do you prepare your bowlers for them?
It is. They are an outstanding side, and they play real positive cricket. We are aware of the challenges that exist in this game. And I think our plans are pretty much in place, and we are up for the challenge.